Hi guys, this is Belal Khan and you are watching Simplified Coding. Welcome all of you to this brand new series where we are going to learn building a complete Android application from scratch. And this app is about wallpapers. You can explore this type of application in Play Store. Already there are number of wallpaper applications, so you can explore some of the applications for getting some idea about this project. So I was getting this request from a long time that I should publish a complete series about developing a complete Android application. So guys, don't worry, here it is now, and it will contain everything from web admin panel to user Android application. Now let's think about the modules of this project. It is a very simple application, so we have only two modules. The first thing is admin module. Our application will display wallpapers to the user, and user can download and share the images or wallpapers. But the point is from where these images will come on the application. So for this, we need an admin who will upload images, manage categories, and will perform other tasks. The thing is, if this is my application, I need a separate area where I will log in and then I will upload the wallpapers. Then these wallpapers will be stored in the database, and then in the user application, we will fetch all the images category wise to display to the user. So this is the basic idea behind our project. I hope you all got the point. We will develop the admin module as a web application and we will host it into Firebase hosting. Okay, so we are going to learn developing a web app as well in this series. The second module is the user module, and it is the Android application itself that we will publish on the Play Store so that everyone can download it. Okay, pretty simple. Now let's discuss about the tools that we are going to use for this project. Everything is absolutely free, so don't worry. The first thing is Node.js. This is needed for making a local server for the admin panel. As I already told you that we are going to make a web app for the admin area, and as the backend of our application is in Firebase, so we need to use JavaScript for the admin web app. And for this, we need Node.js. Then as the IDE for our web application, I am going to use Visual Studio Code. You can use other IDE if you want. It's completely up to you. So these two tools, Visual Studio Code and Node.js, is for developing the admin panel. After developing the admin panel, we will need Android Studio for developing the user application. And yes, I'm going to use Java in Android Studio. Okay, we are not going to waste any time in installation. So I request everyone to please get all the tools and get your machine ready. If you don't know from where you can get these things, the links are given in the description of this video. Okay, you just need to go to the links, download the tool according to your system platform, and then install it as you install any other system program. Okay. So what we are going to do in this series? So friends, first we will develop the admin panel. And for this, we need Node.js and Visual Studio Code. So no Android Studio while we develop the admin panel. And after finishing the admin panel, we will start the Android Studio project to develop our wallpaper application. Finally, I will tell you how you can monetize your application using AdMob. And if you can make a good user base for your application, then you can also earn some decent amount from AdMob. So we will also learn how we integrate AdMob with our application. Then finally, we will publish this application to Google Play Store. Now honestly, I don't know how long it will take. Currently, I'll be working on two series. The first one is the TypeScript tutorial series, and the second is this wallpaper application series. I will try my best to post 3 videos on both playlists every week. Okay. Now our first task here is completing the admin panel, and for this we will be using Bootstrap framework with HTML and CSS for designing the front end, JavaScript and jQuery for the application, and our backend is Firebase, so we will be using many Firebase services like storage, database, push notification, authentication, etc. So friends, this was only an introductory video. If you are excited about the series, then please give me a like, and don't worry, I will post the next video within 2 days. Till then, if you are not familiar with Bootstrap, HTML, JavaScript, etc., then you can get your hands into these, and you can use W3 schools to learn the basics. These are very easy. It will take a single day only to go through the basics. So please do it, and then we will meet in the next video. Bye-bye.